Hi, welcome. This is Clemens at Elector. Hi, I'm making snickerdoodles and they're almost ready. They smell excellent. I'll let them cool down a bit before tasting them. In this video, I will show you how to make snickerdoodles, that cookie that is so popular in the USA, but almost unknown in the rest of the world. Maybe this video will change that. So good. Usually snickerdoodles are made with cinnamon, but in this video we will make them with Linux flavor. As ingredients for our snickerdoodles, we need about 7 billion transistors. Here we go. Some printed circuit board. And some connectors to taste. For my Linux flavored snickerdoodles, I like to use Xilinx Zinc. Because we want them crunchy on the outside and soft on the inside, I always use type XC7Z, which is marked on the side of the package. The recipe is simple, just put all the ingredients in the bowl of a mixer, like so. And the circuit board. And mix everything together. Now it is very important that you So that is why you never want to do that. When you mix too long, the transistor networks will become too big and your snickerdoodle will be tough on the inside instead of soft. Our dough is now ready. Scoop out some and put it on a cookie sheet. I'll make two. Put them in the oven and bake them for about 10 minutes on 200 degrees Celsius. They look great. To flavor the snickerdoodles, copy the Ubuntu image from the Kurtkal website to an SD card. Now you must finalize the SD card by copying some files from the folder on the SD card that corresponds to your hardware setup to the root of the SD card. Also, edit the configuration file to set up the network. The snickerdoodle needs network access so you can SSH into it. The network can be wired or wireless. Finally, carefully insert the micro SD card into the snickerdoodle's SD card holder. Comme ça. This will ensure that the snickerdoodle will be soft on the inside. You want a really soft inside, so that it's easy to reconfigure the snickerdoodle and you can make it do whatever you want it to do. The nice thing about the crunchy outside is that you can manipulate the snickerdoodle without breaking it and you don't get your fingers dirty. So crunchy on the outside. For a nice presentation, plug the snickerdoodle on top of a pie smasher board, slightly out of the center to create some artistic tension. Come on. I run this in a virtual machine on Windows 10 running 64-bit Ubuntu 1604 LTS. The Xilinx software does not run on a 32-bit system. In its documentation, snickerdoodle manufacturer Kurtkal uses Ubuntu 1604 with Vivado 2016.4. But this is quite old. However, Vivado 2020.1 has not been tested with Ubuntu 20.04. And Vivado 2016.4 is no longer supported by the Xilinx Download Manager. I therefore chose a solution in between, Vivado 2018.2 together with Ubuntu 1604. When the download has completed, on Ubuntu you must allow execution of the file by ticking the box Allow Executing File as Program on the Permissions tab. Move the downloaded file to your home folder and open a terminal to execute it. The download will now be unpacked and the installer is started. This can take a while depending on your computer. Fill in your Xilinx account credentials, agree to everything, and make sure to select the webpack. The Vivado download is big, about 8 GB, and it requires about 36 GB disk space. So I set the hard disk for my virtual machine to 50 GB. As I have Vivado already installed, I will cancel at this point. You can now update the path to simplify using the SDK. The path depends on the version of the SDK, so as an example, you can download my path from the description below. Log out and log in again to apply the new path. With the bash command which, we check if the SDK is available and responding. If it is, we can launch it with the command xsdk. When the SDK is ready, we can create a little test project, a small Hello World application that will run on the Snickerdoodle. I use a little trick to make it easier to copy a file to the Snickerdoodle. Linux purists, please close your eyes. First, using SSH, I set the permissions of the user bin folder on the Snickerdoodle to 777. Then I use secure copy, SCP, to copy the executable to the Snickerdoodle. With SSH you can now execute it. This saves you a lot of fiddling with the Snickerdoodle's SD card. Okay, that's it. The development environment for your Snickerdoodle is now up and running and you can start creating applications for it. I hope you found it interesting and thank you for watching.